If you are actually in one of my classes through McHenry County College, you can go to the page for this assignment and you can link to my flowchart, which will allow you to copy the flowchart and modify it for the homework assignment that you'll be doing this week. This is the flowchart. There's two pages to it because it's going to be used on a simple program in processing that's allowing us to get into interactive, event-driven programming. So if you take a quick look at the program that the flowchart matches, you'll see we have our global variables at the top, we have our setup function, and we have our mousepressed function. So here is the main logic for the program. We create our global variables, we call setup, which will run only once, then we call draw, which will run until the user closes the window, and then it will end the program. So when you see a predefined process in here, it will take you, you'll have to go look for that name at the beginning of another sequence of logic. So here, we'll follow through the logic and go back and forth with the program. I enter the shapes program, and the first thing that I do is I create my x and my y variables. I create them by giving them a variable type, which would be integer, giving them a variable name, which would be x, and then I've chosen to initialize the value of x to 0 and the value of y to 0. The next step in my logic is to go to the setup function. That logic begins here. In setup, I set the size, which is right here, 600 by 900. Then I create and color a rectangle, which I've called top. And so I set a fill color for that, and my rectangle starts at 0, 0 for its x, y coordinates. Its width is the width of the screen. Its height is 1/3 the height of the screen. Then I create and color my middle rectangle. My middle rectangle starts at 0 for x, height divided by 3, width, and its height is height divided by 3 because I want it to be 1/3 of the screen. When I create and color the bottom rectangle, I give it a fill color, and then I'm doing height times 2/3, width, and then height divided by 3, because I want this to be 2/3 of the way down the screen. So when I run just this portion, I'm not going to get into the interactive draw portion, it is actually running, I'm just not going to do anything with it. It creates rectangles in 3 colors, dividing the screen into 3 equal parts. Y along here is 0, Y at the joining between the green and the blue is 300. This point where we're moving into the third color, the Y value is now 600. So let's go to the draw. I could use this link. It's a hyperlink to my draw page, but I think it's a little easier just to click on the draw tab at the top. Now the draw logic directly relates to my draw program. When I get into draw, the first thing I do is set my fill color to white, 255, and I make my x variable, which I no longer need to declare because I declared it as a global variable, I set x equal to the x value of the mouse pointer, which in processing is called mouse x. I set y equal to the mouse value of the y value of the mouse pointer, which would be mouse y. And then I get into my if statement. The if statement is mouse pressed. If mouse pressed equals equals true. You'll notice that I have two equal signs here. One equal sign here. This is the assignment variable. It is assigning the value of mouse y to my y variable. This is the comparison operator, where it's comparing this side to this side to see if they have the same value. If that is true, then the following code will occur. So it's going to check to see if the y value of the mouse is less than 300. If that's true, it will draw an ellipse. So you can see the logic a little more clearly here. If y is less than 300, draw a circle at mouse point. If y is between 300 and 600, draw a square at mouse point. If y is between 600 and 900, draw a triangle at mouse point. So here we have our rectangle and our triangle based on the y value. Let's try it. So if I click up here, I should get a circle, and I do. Anywhere in there, you'll notice if I'm right on the line here, it's either circle or square. This band is square, and this band is a triangle. Now, it's very important to notice that I'm using else if. What else does is it stops the code. If this statement is found to be true, it doesn't go any further. If I only had a series of if statements here, it would react differently. Because if you have a value of 150, this will be true. 150 will be less than 300. But 150 will also be less than 600 and less than 900. So if I'm using if, not else if, everything that's true will run. So here I get all three shapes because it's less than all of those options. Here I get two shapes, and here I just get one shape. So else makes a big difference. It makes it quit looking through the rest of that nested if sequence. So you want to make sure to get the objectives from our flowchart, you want to make sure that you are using else if, not simply if. And that will give you just one shape depending on where you're clicking.